the industry is always changing, which is why whenever you meet someone who's an altacocker like me, is that hopefully the first words out of their mouth is, I don't understand why you want to get into this business. It's the worst it's ever been. Because as someone who is entering a business, when you hear someone saying that, it means there's a world of opportunity that somebody who's been in for too long is unwilling to adapt to. And so that means you have an opening for you. So the big thing where people are saying it's worse than ever right now is that we have streaming, which has kind of messed up with syndication models, which has kind of messed up with feature film release patterns and all of that. And plus we have what's going on in the agency world with the packaging being seriously enough a conflict of interest among the agents to where you have the Writers Guild fighting against it. So this looks like chaos. But what it actually means is it means that there's a shakedown coming, and usually from a shakedown, you have a rising of low budget. And the beauty of low budget and the beauty of in publishing, let's say, is that audiences still want to get connected emotionally. And the reason why the big companies start doing increasingly big paydays that end up being disappointments is that they're not looking at why people are reading. They're not looking at why people are going to the movie. They're only looking at the bling. They're completely ignoring the core. And that's why you'll have something like a Harry Potter come out of nowhere. That's why you'll have shock bestsellers. I'm sorry, I'm always referring to old things, but when The Joy Luck Club came out and was a huge bestseller, no one anticipated it, to the point where all of the prints of it were small prints. And then they did how many printings, like 150 or something like that, because they couldn't believe the book was a success. Yet it was filling a niche. And that's where the opportunity is today as well. I think that you're seeing, you know, Hollywood is saying diversity, but they're not really understanding. They're not really understanding what diversity truly is. Diversity isn't only, oh, we're going to cast this minority in it, or we're going to have this element in it. No, what the diversity is finding the commonality. It's like, why was My Big Fat Greek Wedding a hit? It was a hit because even though it was about a specific culture and it had a lot of details in it, was still familiar. Same with Crazy Rich Asians. Crazy Rich Asians is filling in a romantic gap that Hollywood isn't providing. And that's why, as a small movie, it made a lot of money. That's why the book worked. I mean, I can tell you that an average Asian person is going to look at the book or the movie Crazy Rich Asians and get irritated with it because it's very... outsider looking in, but for an average mainstream culture person, they'll look at it and they'll see a whole different world that they didn't realize was so similar to their own lives, and that's what the diversity is. It's finding the commonality, and that's where real success comes from. And that only can come from independence. When you have a budget of $200 million, you cannot be specific. You cannot have details that are enriching because you're running the risk of alienating people. But if you have a smaller budget, you can make every single thing about it a gem. And this is true in books too. If you focus on an area or an audience that appears to be niche, and you get that niche to definitely recommend it, it'll explode outwards. And then all of a sudden, everyone will want to read it. That's what happened with Joy Luck Club. Why would anyone read this book where the dust jacket had a misprint on it? They were so, well, no one's gonna buy this. And it had that detail. It had that specificity, and I think that's the key for writing a character, for writing something that's commercial, is to is to understand what the real audience is. The real audience wants to get connected.